Hey there, TreeCache fans. The following is a video of my first TreeCache, and I took my son with me on this little adventure for his birthday. And unfortunately, some of the audio didn't come through when we were shooting that day, so I'm gonna try and fill some of that in this video for you. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it. Hey, my name is Derek. I'm with Higher Ground Tree Care out of Granger, Indiana. And this is my son, Jack. Say hi.
Hello.
And we are here at Tree 51 on our first TreeCache adventure. Jack, how old are you going to be tomorrow?
9.
Jack is going to be 9 years old tomorrow. He loves to climb, and this is one of his birthday trip presents. So we've got all our gear laid out here on the truck. We're just doing a quick gear inspection. We're going to pack it all in and head out on the trail and see if we can find this tree. So we're here at the trailhead, just leaving the parking lot, and we've already run into our first obstacle. There is a trail here. It's a dirt path that goes into the woods. There's another trail over there that is paved and heads off in a different direction. Not 100% sure on which trail we need to take, but we are going to opt for this dirt trail that goes into the woods. Hopefully that'll be the right decision and the wrong one. Jack?
What?
I'm blaming you if this is the wrong trail. We'll find out. All right, we've hit another split in the trail. We've got a left and a right. Mm-hmm. Which way are we going, dude?
Right.
We're going to the right. We're gonna keep staying right. And I think that eventually these woods should open up into a sands dune, I believe, based on the coordinates we have for the tree. And hopefully we're heading in the right direction still. So you can see here, as we're hiking through the woods, that the terrain is changing from woods and it's opening up. You can see the trail that has become sand. And unfortunately for us, on this particular day, is about 90 plus degrees outside, and we're about to leave the nice cover of the woods and be baked in the sun. So we're nearing the tree. The hike is a little challenging due to the fact that it's pretty much all sand once you clear the woods. Jack sees the opening. When we get over this ridge, we should be able to see Lake Michigan, and we should be pretty close to our tree. Fun fact, I've got a Notch Pro gear bag. Love this bag. I've had it for about 2 years now. Super rugged, durable, fits all my gear for work. But it also can fit my 200-foot climbing line, my son's 100-foot climbing line, an adult harness, a child's harness, two helmets, two safety lanyards, and all our carabiners and hitches in between. All fits in my one bag, which is nice. Except for the fact that now I've got about 75 to 80 pounds on my back hiking on a sand dune in my boots. It's a little challenging, but makes for a more pleasant experience for my son, so he didn't have to carry all his stuff. So that's a win.
Okay, so this is the last incline up to the top of the sand dune. There's this really cool red oak that's growing out, all kinds of crazy. It was pretty neat, and to kind of stoop down to get under it. But then as you get up to the top of the dune, this is a pretty steep hike. There's actually a point here where I was on my hands and knees climbing up this. But then you've got this amazing view as the woods break, and you can see from the top of the dune Lake Michigan out in front of you. And it's just pretty awesome once you get up here to just kind of take a break for a second and just overlook the lake and all that's going on. It's beautiful. So we're still at the top of the sand dune here, and Jack has spotted the TreeCache bucket. You can kind of see it hanging there. They did something really cool, and they made the bucket camouflage. So it's really hard to spot, but Jack managed to spot it anyway through the trees. I was pretty impressed.
All right, we're at the base of the tree. Where is it? This tree, right here. It's a nice big red oak. Jack spotted the bucket for us. It's pretty interesting because you actually spot the bucket from on top of the dune, and then you gotta hike all the way down to get to the base of the tree. Should be a fairly simple climb, but we're pretty tired, so we still gotta set our lines, get geared up, and get up there. See if we can make it.
So it's pretty bummed that I didn't get audio on this clip, but I'm just talking about what we're climbing on. I'm climbing on a Unisender here, and Jack's gonna be climbing on a hitch cord. He's tying a Michoacan, and he's worked really hard to learn how to tie this hitch, and he's talking through how he's tying his knot. So he does 4 wraps with his hitch cord, and then he brings that over top of the bottom eye, behind his primary line, and then back up through one of his loops, and then he brings both eyes together and clips in. But he likes to climb on the Michoacan. It's a nice compact knot for him, and it's safe, and he does a good job tying it. It can be difficult for young climbers because they don't always have the weight necessary to be able to ascend and descend with a hitch cord, but he does pretty good. Here's the beginning of Jack's climb. He's just getting started. Here's the end of Jack's climb. He did a really good job. It was about a 45 to 50 foot climb, which is a bit high for him. He doesn't always climb that high, but he did a good job. He worked really hard to get up there and really muscled through. So here we are. We finally arrived at the bucket at the top of the tree, and Jack really struggled getting the lid off, and so I had to help him with that. But it's pretty awesome. The bucket had a congratulations note on the back of the lid, and some instructions for you that Jack read through. It's really kind of a sense of accomplishment to be able to find this tree and then be able to get up into it to access the bucket. We met a lot of people along our hike that were kind of like, what are you guys doing? And kind of explained the trio caching thing with them, and they thought it was pretty cool. But none of them were going to get to experience it, because none of them were going to be able to climb up 50 feet into a tree to access the bucket. So it's kind of a unique thing for us. And Jack took forever and a day to pick out his prize that he wanted. And it's kind of cool because you can leave behind something in the bucket if you bring it with you. We didn't think to bring anything with us, but I'm pretty sure Jack picked out something that someone had made by hand. It has a little bracelet made out of paracord. It was really cool, and he loves it. So it's kind of neat that someone left that behind for him to be able to get. But it was quite an awesome adventure for us. We had a great time. We'll definitely be back again sometime. And it was a lot of fun, something to do with my family.